Hello, my name is Nupur Shah, and today the topic given to me is trigger finger. So here we begin. Starting with the introduction, it is the painful condition which causes the finger or the thumb to catch or lock when bent. That is when it goes for flexion. At that time, the finger suddenly becomes locked in the flexion position, and the extension is very difficult and it is not smooth enough as in normal people. And it happens when the tendon in the finger or the thumb becomes inflamed, and usually the tendon glides easily within the sheath, but where it gets inflamed, flexion of the finger or bending the finger can pull the inflamed tendon through the tendon sheath, and it creates the sound of a snap or a pop. The most common fingers are the ring finger, middle finger and the thumb, and females are more affected than males. As you can see the picture of the digit, there are 5 annular pulleys and 3 cruciform pulleys. So the trigger finger happens at the A1 pulley. Here it happens. As you can see the picture, it shows the inflamed tendon in the index finger. What are the causes of a trigger finger or the trigger thumb? The common cause is repeated movements because of the person's occupation. Then gout, rheumatoid arthritis, diabetes, hypothyroidism patients have more chances to get this disease. And grasping the power tool for a long period of time can also lead to this disease. Like I said, it is occupational related disease. Symptoms, it is pain, swelling, catching, a tender lump is felt at the affected finger. And stiffness and catching tend to be worse after inactivity, and morning stiffness will be positive in such patients. Differential diagnosis, if it is the trigger thumb, then the differential diagnosis of De Quervain's disease can be considered. Otherwise, it is MCP joint sprain or MCP joint arthritis or Dipterans cord fracture. Outcome measure is the scale used is the DASH scale. Grip strength is measured by the dynamometer, and NPRS, that is numerical pain rating scale, can be used. Treatment is usually through corticosteroid injections or NSAIDs medicine, and as a physiotherapist we can prescribe this trigger finger splint as shown in the picture. Here the physiotherapist is giving the trigger finger release, and the exercise is shown in the picture. The band which is there on the digits of the patient has to move the digits away from each other and then approximate it. So these exercises can be done. Thank you.